folks, welcome back. Outdoors Dave, on a wee lake today doing a bit of pike fishing. Good set up and all, a brew. It's not too cold today, dead on. It's about 7 degrees and the time is 5 to 8. So hopefully we get a pike today and let you see the score. I would usually bring maggots with me, ground bait, and have a feeder rod out there. It's abundant with roach and perch in there, but today, unfortunately, I don't have it because we couldn't get any maggots from any tackle shops. So, we'll just stick with the two pike rods today, see how it goes. Weather forecast is to be dry. Saying that, you never know. Probably skip for rain as it come down, set with Europe, but hopefully it stays dry. So we're just waiting. I'll bring this back once I land. Alright folks, I'll just take you through some of the bait that I use. Mackerel tails, half mackerel. They're a bit big, so I would cut them a couple of centimetres off them. The head, I use the head, a lot of people don't, but I do. And then here I have a lot of bait in here. It's all frozen. It's all good bait. It's all mackerel, sardines, roach. Again, mackerel tails. They've been hanging quite a while. I never throw my bait out, I always bring it back and refreeze it because I don't see the point of throwing it out. Not there, it's been froze maybe 3 times, but to me, when that thaws out, it's smelly, it's pungent, and it attracts the fish. In my eyes, they'll go for it. I've got 2 mackerel tail on now. At the minute. And in here we have some herring. I'll try later on. I've never actually tried those before, so I'll give them a shot later. See what happens with them. So plenty of bait. Always have plenty of bait. But you never know. You get a really good day, and then again, you get a really crap day where you're blank. I've blanked a lot of times, but to be honest, it doesn't bother me. You know, everyone likes to catch fish, yes, but if you're blank, you're blank. It's part of fishing. Not all the time you're going to go out and you're going to catch, you know? And it doesn't, as I say, it doesn't bother me at all. It's about getting out, getting your line in the water and your bait out. That's what it's about for me, you know? You've seen my rods set up, I've showed you before. Shakespeare rods, Shimano reels. 18 pound break of string line. It's a nice lake this year. I've fished it a lot of times. It's abundant, as I said, with roach and perch. If I had to have maggots, I'd have been sitting there with a feeder on all day, bringing them in. Put them in a little keep net, weigh them, then release them all back. a few photographs of a couple of times I've been down here with them in the keep net. I'll actually put them on and let you see. Or as I say, couldn't get any maggots, so just one of those things. And this is the lake. I have a little video on of a, I don't know what you would call it, a little mink or stoat or something in the water swimming across. I have it on actually on my channel, and it came from in there, just in there. There's a big hole there and it seemed to be living in there. I fished this lake for about, I'd say 15 years. My biggest pike out of here would have been 9.5 pound. To me, that's all right. Get a jack pike, you get a jack pike. I've never caught a monster pike out of here, but there would be big pike in here. The lake actually goes right round to the right there. Now and again, you would see a wee man with his boat sitting in there by the weeds. I've never seen him catch anything, but that's not to say he hasn't. One time I fished the other side and the farmer came and asked me to move on, so like, he was dead on, he was no problem. The reason why he doesn't let anybody fish the other side, his land, because of rubbish. Down here's not bad. The little farmer comes down, you give him £2, there's a bag over there for your rubbish, you put your rubbish in it, he comes down, takes the rubbish away, leaves the place nice and clean, which is great. I'll just show you the lake. So this is the lake, folks. As I say, I have a bait out there and one out there, and that's where it goes round to the right, round there. Quite big. Now it's great for parking because there's a little rubbish bag and the ladders the farmer leaves for you. My bike's just up there on the lay-by on the road, which is great. So we'll just chill out and wait for the bait alarms to go, and hopefully I get a video of bringing a fish in, so you just de-hook it, weigh it, and safely return it back to the lake. Well, folks, we're in. Didn't take too long. Yep, we're in. Well, that's what I'm looking for. That was good. Little run. 8:10. That's great. So I'll just fix this bait here and get it back out again. Now that's what I'm looking for. Got a mark on the bait there where it's the pike's been biting on. Happy days. So, bit of bait elastic around this. hopefully we can get her again, folks. Well, that's what it's all about for me. Get that buzz, get the fish on. Unfortunately, I let it go, but here, not to worry. I would say, tugging on the bait. Say maybe 6-7 pound fish. So, we'll just wait again. See what happens. It's wrecked. Now we have to change over this bit. But I'll do it. Okay, folks, for a fresh bit of bait on. These pigs give me the run around here. But
not to worry.
Just cast this out, same spot. And hopefully we'll get her. Okay, folks, had a bit of a problem there. Got stuck on the bottom. Lost. Got the loop back. Not to worry. Sorted. Fresh bit of mackerel on. Let's get this cast out in the same spot. Pike's giving me a bit of a run around here, but it's all good, actually, come on. Busy morning. Well, looking positive anyway. We're quite well, we're hungry. Just hopefully one takes the bait. Unfortunately, we had a go again. Look at it. It's hungry. As you can see, it's definitely playing with me. This is good. We'll get it. Well, folks, lots of action this morning. This is Pike, seems to be very hungry. A lot of people say fish are not smart. I would debate that. I would say they know. So we'll just wait again. Well, it's been a productive morning so far. Time for a brew and a bite to eat. Get a bit of breakfast. And hopefully, we'll get an hour run. And maybe, hopefully, catch it. Thank you. big water in Carrick, the little waterfall would be fresh. I wouldn't drink this lake water. Never have tried it before, so just weird. There's a bit of a green algae in it there this morning, so just stick to this. Sometimes it quiets down, you just don't take the feed for a couple of hours and then they get back on the feed. So you can bait these here, coffee and wait. Just pick the bait up on the left hand rod here. So let's see what happens. Could have been another fish swimming by the lane, hitting the lane, which makes the indicator go up, but you just have to wait and see. Sometimes the pike will lift the bait and sip it in its mouth. And hopefully it just gets it. also on. Okay, folks. But I want the folks to sue you.
That's done.
So, we're coming down here with a deep hook. End of the net. We'll keep that. We'll rest it. Then we'll sue you it. I wonder if this is the one that's been at me most of the morning. Happy days. It's not a blank. You can see, it's took the mackerel. Bit of blood off me. Back interesting weather. It's great. This is probably here, this is pike, trying to get away, but she's in the net, she can't harm herself, which I like, I don't like harming the fish. This bag out and then we'll deal with this pike. Bait runner. Good to go. Right. Let's get a weight of this fish. Little set of scales here. There she is. 9.2. Happy days. 9.2. Okay folks, let's release her. Unharmed, which I like to do. Nice healthy fish. Couple of leeches on it. So there is, but she's good. Hope you all can see it. 9.2. Sorry about that, folks. Didn't mean that for that to happen. Thank you. Yeah, I must apologize there. Didn't mean to do that. Smaller one this time. Great stuff. Someone's caught this pike before. We're not going to weigh this one. I would say it's about 3.5 pounds, 4 pounds. Let's get her back. You see this damage, as you say. Okay, folks, brilliant. That pig was a bit damaged. That's what happens when you don't get people and they don't know how to deal with it. Part of his jaw was busted, unfortunately. There's people out there who just don't know what they're doing. But she's way back safe enough, which I like. Happy days. Let's get this rope gated up again and get it out. Hey folks, I'll just show you. That's what was in the pike's mouth. If you can see this, someone's trace.
Oh, for a lamp it is.
Nope, she didn't want it this time.
We're having plenty of action today. Which is good.
Saying there, wire trace in the pike's mouth. People just don't know how to dehook the pike properly and just cutting it, leaving the hook in its mouth, which to me it's kind of poor angling, because you're leaving a hook in its mouth. I would think it'd be hard for the fish to feed. Trying to pass the bit of fish food by the hook. Don't understand it myself. But unfortunately, that's what you're up against. Most apologies again for mishandling that pig. Sort of like grabbed me and did drop it. So, didn't want to do that. Well, carry on here. Hopefully get another one in the net. Well, that was good. Pretty action there. Most apologies again for dropping the fish. Impressive little things. Not too bad. I've had worse. Again, that trace. The last person to catch that pig, or maybe the person before, it looked fresh. It's broke the side of its gill. Bit of a hole in it. And the trace was actually stuck in its mouth. So, luckily enough, I got it out. The hook was down its belly. There's no point trying to pull, because it'll kill the fish, damage it badly. So the best thing to do was snip it off and get it out. As you've seen there, from my line, I have a trace, and then my hook trace, using a little snap-on swivel. Again, it's easy just to snap it off, take your rod out of the way, and work with the fish. It's a lot easier, nothing tangling about, fish not getting wrapped in your line. And that's what I've done there. As you've seen, hooks come out, back in the water. That's all my mackerel used. I've dropped these heads, and bits of tail, bits of body. What I will be doing with these is keeping them. On Friday, I'll go to the tackle shop. I'm going to buy a little barbecue rig. And it's basically just a long rig with treble hooks. And you barbecue, you put different bits of fish on. Loads of smell and scent coming off that. And that's what we'll keep those for. I've never tried one before, so I'll test them on Friday before Saturday. We're back out again, me and Stephen. Don't know where we're going yet, so we'll give that a go on Saturday and hopefully land a pike on it. It's not a blank. Every angler likes to catch fish, you know, but you won't go out and you'll spend all day on the lake and you'll not get nothing. And my way, I think, well done to the pike. Unlucky for me. Bring his bag when I get one. Okay, folks. Right on road. Left on road side, where's the gear? Big gear. That's a good cross with it. Like I said, it'll lift the bait, as you see. It'll sit with it in its mouth. What we're looking for is it to take it so we can strike and get a fish on. Still got it. The next time it goes, I'll strike the one swallowing the bait, where the bait's in its belly. I'd rather loss a fish than have it hooks stuck in its belly. That way the fish is okay. Just didn't catch it. Two fish on both rods. My goodness. Not unless it swam over the line, which could be a possibility. So we'll wait and see what happens. Like I said, I have one more mackerel tail left, and then I'll be changing on to the hern. Never fished with hern before, so it'll be interesting to see. And I know pike take hern. I've just never used them before, so I'll give it a go. See what happens. going to slacken the lane off, take away any resistance. Pike made free. Like it's just lifted it, ran with it, and dropped it. That's what they do. So, we'll wait. Well, folks, run again. Yep, we're in. Just make myself a cup of coffee here. Nice fish. So, open it in the bag. Put it in the water and let it rest. Okay. You can see, bleeding again. But not to worry. Just get a bit better than that here. Well, the pigs. Okay, so it's getting a bit there. That's weird. Thank you. so. £5.3. Oh, you can see that. £5.3. So, nice pig. Another pig safety return to the water. Happy days. So we'll get this booted up again and then we'll get back out the water. Well, that was good. As I say, I was just about to make myself a brew. Changed my bait over on the left hand rod there. I've got herring on the left hand one and mackerel still on the right hand rod. I've no mackerel left. Well, bits of heads are what I might use. See how it goes on the herring anyway. As I say, I've never tried it before, so it'll be interesting to see. I'll just enjoy this cup of coffee and hopefully get another one. Well, it's going very quiet. It is now 2:45. Had nothing from earlier. So, get a quick cup of coffee, bit of lunch, and see what happens. Maybe just stayed after 4. Pack up about 4 o'clock. Before the traffic gets heavy. great day for pegging. Dull. The wind's actually blowing to me. It's not too hard, just a light wind. To me, this is perfect weather for pegging. Say we're back out on Saturday. It'll be interesting to see where we're going. Stephen, being the driver, so he would know a lot of places over the motorway where I can't get to. In fact, I can only stick the B-roads on the motorbike. So when you're with Stephen, you get the adventure of new places, exploring roads and rocks. Head down over the border, down south. I've been reading up on Fermanagh. It's a big lake down there. And the pike, this monster pike in there. I think the biggest one I seen that took out there was on Wee Magazine this year. 37, 38 pounds or something like that. That's extremely big. I was picking up one of those. But you say, I had enough to sit here. But 8 pound fish, 5 pound fish. Not level one earlier. The one that I didn't weigh was damaged. I would say I was about 3-4 pounds, if that. Quite the same, right? As you said earlier on, I got that one. Pretty bad damage. But it's Suji, it's in there and it's feet. I also have my feeder rod out on Saturday. Hopefully get some maggots, ground bait. I enjoy fishing for roach. I've came here before in the summertime and just fished all day for roach. Great. Got a quiver tip rod. Lots of fun. Also going to try a rig. It's called a Sickle Float. I've seen it on YouTube. I've seen a guy use it last Saturday, a lot of boy. So I'm going to invest, get one, have a go at that. Basically the float sinks under the water and your bait comes off on another trace with a weight at the bottom. Kind of bait it down so it can get tangled. Lifts it up, lifts, keeps your bait just off the bottom. So I'll buy one of those and give that a go. See what it's like. I mainly just dead bait. very rarely I use the float, even pike fishing. I float fish for trout. When I'm pike fishing, I'm always on the bottom. It's just the way I like it. It's my kind of method of and as you see, it works. So, good little lunch today. Hopefully bring this back. Well folks, it's late afternoon. It's almost 5 o'clock, so I think I'll finish this cup of coffee. Pack my gear up and head home. Had a good day now. As you've seen, a couple of runs, 3 fish. Happy enough for that. Very quiet for a while now. So again, thanks for watching. If you like what you see, like and subscribe to Outdoors Dave. If you want to say anything, just leave them in the comments below. Well folks, see you next time.